Hello everyone, time for the Warframe update. I'm glad that drought is over. Now, there'll be no showcase for today since this togs up my time, since I gotta complete this as best I can. We'll start off with additions. I also got nice little zoom-in features and everything else on the SHAREfactory since it's been updated. Very nice, makes my videos look better. Anyway, for additions, first we'll start off with the pretty much more complicated thing to explain, but not really, the AI-10 statues. Now, to get one easily, go to Maru, go talk to her, she's in her bazaar, she'll take you to a mission in the void where you do a little obstacle course, you can really cheese it with Zephyr, or it's not really hard, but you can just do what I do, just cheat, and you can get it. Now, the question is, what do these statues do? Well, you can do two things. You can decorate your place with them, or you can sell them back to Maru for ducats. Now you go to them and you can see it's worth 400 ducats, but if you get these item stars though, you find throughout various missions, you can install them. And you see the ducat value increases. So it's up to you if you wish to sell them back to Maru or keep them for yourself. It's all up to you. All now, okay, with that out of the way, we also got weapons. I'll do my pronounce these. Calculist, or Calculatalist, whatever, the Infested Scythe. Corrosive damage only. Good status chance. Yeah. Now, moving on from that, we got the Gazelle Machete. Oh god, another machete. I could say nice things about this weapon, but I have very low hopes. It's like talking about whips in Dark Souls. Then we got the Syndicate weapons, the Rock to Dark Dagger. Nice. Stealth attacks, can restore you to shield, it could possibly get you over shield. Very good, very nice. Next, fixing the weapon we have, we got the Sancti Belt Magister, possibly the most popular. If you hit someone while charged with the heavy attack while using channeling, it will heal nearby allies. Very nice, very good. I've sold a lot of these already. Now we got the Sakura Lecta, the electric whip. Now, the only thing special about this is enemies will probably double the amount of credits they drop. Mediocre idea, but at least has good status, 25%. Then we got the Synoid Helicore, arguably the worst Syndicate weapon of them all. Really slow, it's the weakest Helicore around, and it'll just simply just create a new Spectre for wherever you kill. That's alright, I guess. Then we got the Tello Bolt Ace. Spinning with these, doing a spin attack, well, these will pretty much launch the spines and hit nearby enemies. Pretty neat. Good status chance on this weapon, at 25% as well. Then we got the Vacor Sidon. It causes the radio blind, and you kind of, you know, do the ground slam to trigger it. Very neat. Though, I wonder if it's as good as the original Sidon. I gotta check the stats on that. Now on to stuff I don't have footage for. Okay, for continuing on with additions, we also have the Champion mod set. Now, we don't have immediate access to this on the consoles. This will be an event coming up very shortly. We should see it in our activity feed coming up. I believe it starts on the 17th. So yes, it has a bunch of mods, some weapon-specific mods, etc. Also, all Sentinels now have the Vacuum preset. And to change this about Carrier, as since everyone uses him, his special abilities now, he increases your ammo cap and pretty much, you know, ammo mutation. So yes, Carrier is no longer just a Vacuum. Now, I don't think I need to say this, but you guys have probably seen those resource rocks all around, but I'll put it here anyway if you haven't. Resource now appears in clumps as well as everywhere else. Conclave mode has a new game mode called Variant, which is kind of like SWAT from Halo if you could remember back in the day if you're old enough, where pretty much everyone dies very quickly, like one shot, one kill almost. We also have some new augments for Inaros, Ember, and Valkyr. We also have new emotes as well. We got Kneel, we got the Bent Knee Kneel, and Sit. Alright. We also got a new map for Lunaro, the Perrin Sequence themed map. Very nice. And for normal Conclave, we got the Infestation map that's been added as well. And in Conclave, you now have a Vote for Next Map option. Very nice. And on top of all that, to finish us off, come more Conclave mods. There are various ones. There's too many for me to hear a list. But no matter. Let's move on to changes. And also lumping in with those changes, I'm putting Conclave as well. There are too few changes that I deem important to mention, so I lump it in with Conclave. Alright. Now, to be honest, I only have one really crucial change in the normal game. This Smita Cat, the Gavat, its charm ability now only grants one rare resource. Where it used to be only granting, used to grant us 5 to 7, that's quite broken. We even enjoyed it while it lasted. At least we still get it. But anyway, that's the only significant change I've found. Maybe there's some others, but you can check it on yourself if you're curious. But anyway, let's go to Conclave changes. Now, Conclave, I've took on a lot of the more important ones, but mind you, when it came to nerfs for Warframe power, well, I didn't bother listing them, because there's too damn many. But anyway, let's get started. At least I could mention this one, Loki cannot gain energy while invisible. He must be outside his invisibility to gain energy. Kind of brings more balance. Now, they say weapons added, but I thought we had all the weapons already added, but here they are. Amprex, Flux Rifle, Galaxion, Embolist, Gamma Core Series, Nucor, Spectra, Panthera, the Sobek, Dracoon, Lenka. So yes, I thought those weapons are already added, but yet here they are in the build notes. Whatever. Now on to some status. Heat status duration is now 4 seconds. Freeze fault duration status, or you know, free being frozen, reduces your overall speed. Radiation status is now 6 seconds. Magnetic status duration is now 6 seconds and only removes 50% of your energy. So that's good, it doesn't remove all of it. I hate it when that happens. Now let's go on some weapon buffs. For damage increase, we got the Sicarus, Vectis, the Poison Cloud of the Mulus Cyrenos, Colstar, Castana Series, Atomos, Talons, Stradivar, and the Ogryss as ammo has been increased. And I should at least mention that Mag's Pole's damage has been increased. Anyway, for nerfs though, we've got the Soma Prime, aka Stiletto Prime, Jackajang again, and the Sabir. Because, you know, there's a lot of reasons to use a Sabir in the first place. And this one's a bit of a punch to the gut, but they've removed the combo counters for both melee weapons and snipers. So that's a bit unfortunate, but what can you do? And that seems to wrap it up. Like I said, for the Conclave changes, a lot of Warframe nerfs. If you do go into Conclave, best check it. Just do a quick search on it, because there's way too many from a list. Because, like, every Warframe seems to have something changed on them, because they can't make up their damn minds on Conclave. But no matter. That's been the video for today. I was about to say showcase, but it's not a showcase. I'm too used to doing that. But no matter. I'd like to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Showcase tomorrow. Don't worry.